Hello guys and welcome to Laravel 7 tutorials. So guys, in this video we are going to discuss about how can we edit a record or update a record with custom validation error or custom validation messages. Okay, so let's just start. I will move to Git Bash and I have already accessed my project directory and folder. So what I will do is php artisan serve. Okay, now I will move to okay, it is up and running. Let's move to home. Basically, we created this layout in our previous video and I just wanted to show you that I have already created some new posts so that I can save some time. Right here you can see. Okay, so in here we mine and your records can be different. That is not an issue. All we have to do right here is to see how can we edit or update our records. Okay, so let's just start. First of all, I'm going to basically configure this link. Basically it is taking us nowhere, so let's just configure it. First, resources, views, layout, all posts right here. Okay, I will basically configure this link with a route URL. Whenever we are going to click on this edit button or edit link, what we are going to do is basically we are going to hit a specific route, get post with specific ID. Okay, right here, dollar post ID. Okay, since we are getting all the posts right here from the view, let me just show you post controller and all posts, get all the posts right here. You can see we are getting all the posts right here and we are using for each to print all the posts right here. Okay, now let me just show you that we are having our basically edit links with some ID right here, and you can see we have post ID right here. Let me show you other one. Let's just inspect this one and you can see we have a different ID. Okay, so it is working, and now whenever we are going to click, it is not going to do anything because we don't have any specific route with get post. So let's just configure it. I will move to web.php. Let's configure a route. Route get post with some ID that we are having on the other hand. And I will just say whenever we hit this specific route, what you are going to do is hit a specific method, in this case get post, because we are going to get a specific post so that we can edit it. Okay, now we have a route in place. Let's just create a function, public function get post with specific ID that we are passing right here. Basically we are going to get ID from right here to here. Let me just show you DD dollar ID, any specific ID. Okay, back, refresh, edit, and you can see the post ID is 13 now. Okay, let's edit this one. Basically let's edit this one, and in this case we are going to have ID number 9. Okay, now let's find the specific post so that we can pass it for the edit view page. Post is equals to post find or fill. Let's use find or fill this time, dollar ID. Let's see if we have our post. It is always good to check first that we are having our data right here, and in this case you can see we are having our data right here. Okay, so that we can edit it. And now I'm just going to pass it to a view, but in this case we don't have any sort of view for edit basically post. So in this case I'm just going to create a new post, and for that I'm going to copy everything from this create post layout right here, control C. Okay, now let's create a view. Let's say this time it is going to be basically the name of this page is edit post. That's it, plate.php. okay, let's paste it right here, and we have each and everything. Let's just change it a bit. I will just show you. Let me just recall it right here, return view, and let's say I want layout edit post view. That's it. Let me just show you, refresh, and you can see we are having a new page. Now in this case we need to change create post right here. Let's just do this. Let's say this time edit post, and let's say edit post right here as well. That's it. Okay, now everything remains the same. That is not an issue. Everything is going to be same right here. Okay, and we are only going to basically change the route. In this case, we are going to hit the update route when we submit this form. Okay, and let's change this button submit to update. That's it, simple. And we have everything. We have our CSRF token. Remember that we are using post method basically, so we need to use or we need to define the CSRF token. Okay, everything looks fine. Okay, now on this submit I want to hit this specific route. Let's just create it route, and in this case the condition basically the method is post, and let's say update. And whenever we are going to hit this specific route with post method, what you have to do is, I'm telling Laravel, you have to hit post controller update method. That's it. Let's just create this method right here, public function update, and this time we are going to get the request from this request class, and we are defining basically we are getting the data from request with the help of SQL injection. I have already discussed, basically we have already discussed that in previous videos. DD dollar request. Let's see if we are getting everything. All. Okay, now let's refresh. Okay, let's say up submit. Okay, so we are hitting our route successfully for updating. Now let's get the data right here on the edit post page. Right here, let me show you. See, we have already implemented our form. We just change our action URL, and now we want to have the post title and description. And how are we going to get this? Basically, we are finding the post right here. You can see, let me just align it. Okay, you can see that we are finding the specific post that has specific ID from right here, this page right here. This specific post has 17 ID. We are going to find this and we are passing to this view right here. Let's just get the data in the input fields. How are we going to do that? It is really simple. Let me just show you. We are getting the post and all I have to do is pass the value $post, and let's say I want post name, because we have this type of field in our database right here. Let me show you right here. Okay, let's just refresh and see if we have our data. Post title, basically we are not returning any sort of data right here. You can see we are not compacting our data. So first of all, let's compact our data, and we are going to pass this post without a dollar sign. Refresh again. And you can see we are having our post title right here. Okay, now let's get the description. And for the text area, we are not going to pass the value in the value attribute. Basically for the text area, what you have to do is you have to pass the value, or you can say the description in this case right here between the text area input fields right here. $post description. That's it, simple. Let's get it. Okay, so we are having our description right here, and let's get this show post. How are we going to get this? Basically we are going to put a condition, and the condition is basically ternary in this case, $post is underscore active equals to one. What are you going to do basically if this condition, basically this is a ternary condition, and we are checking if post is active column is equals to one, then what you have to do is you are going to check this input field checked, and else do nothing. That's it. Let's refresh. In this case we are going to have a tick. Why? Because we are getting all the posts that are is active from right here from the database. See, we have many many posts, and we are only getting the posts that are active right here. You can see we have three posts, that basically the four posts in this case that are active, but one is basically the soft deleted. So we are not going to get the soft deleted post. Okay, it is really simple. Now let's get the data right here. Okay, let's refresh. edit. I want to edit this post. We are having our data. Let's say update. On update, we want to validate this field, these fields, and apply some custom validation messages, and then we are going to update it. So let's do this first. We'll just comment it out. Okay, now for the show post, I'm going to apply a condition, because in Laravel, whenever you have a checkbox field, if it is not ticked, let me just show you, it is going to show you nothing. See, basically we are not using DD. And let's remove comment out this one. This is all for the explanation, guys. Let's just remove it, update, and you can see we are not having any sort of show post. Let's update, and you can see we are having a field show post on. If this field is not checked, we are not going to get anything. So I'm going to apply a condition right here. Show post is equals to, again I'm going to apply a ternary condition, dollar request, and I'm going to get this field if this right here, copy, if request show post equals to null. What you are going to do is basically, if this is true, what you have to do is apply 0. Else, if this condition is false, what you have to do is assign 1. Let's DD our show post right here. Simple. And let's comment it out so that we can see our result. Let's say we are having our show post tick. We are having 1 for show post value. Let's uncomment it. And we are having value 0. So you can see, this is why we are implementing our condition right here. Okay, now it's time to validate our post data. Let's say dollar request. For validation, we are going to use validate, and it is going to accept an associative array with basically the input field's name right here, from right here, the name attribute right here. And I want this field to be required, and I want it to be minimum of 3 characters and max of 191 characters. That's it. And for the post description, from right here, let me just show you so that there is no confusion. Left post description right here, and I want this required and minimum of 3 characters right here, and maximum of 191. That's it. Okay, now I want to put basically the custom validation error messages, or custom error messages, you can say custom validation messages, whatever you can say. And for that, we are going to pass another array so that we can apply our custom error messages for the specific field. But I'm going to do post underscore title. Now whenever we are having this post title field required error, what we are going to get is from right here. I will just copy it from right here to save some time, and I'm going to explain it to you again. If you want to basically, if you want to know about this, what you can do is you can watch it from the previous video where we implemented this conditions for validation. I have defined it in great detail in those videos, and I will just pass it right here. Let's say move it from here, because the fields name are same, so we can apply it right here as well. So let me just explain it to you. Whenever we are having post title dot required field error, we are going to print this error. And whenever we are going to have post title dot minimum error, what we are going to do is basically we are passing this specific error from right here, basically the custom error message. Okay, and we are doing same for the other one. What you have to do is basically you have to concatenate input field name with the error name that you want to change, basically in this case dot required, min, max, etc. Okay, now when the validation is done, let's just pass the ID of that specific post that we are getting right here. Basically you can see we are passing the post name. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to define an input hidden field, and let's name it post ID, specific post ID that we want to update, and value is dollar post id. Okay, simple. Basically, let me just show you with a demonstration. Basically, in this case, when we click on edit, we are going to find the specific post related data. Let me just show you, we are getting the data, and let me show you the hidden field that we just defined right here. You can see we are having this specific post ID right here and right here. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to find the post after it is validated. Let's just find it, dollar post, find dollar request, not required, bulky request, and post underscore ID. Post, let me just check the name from right here, right here, copy. I want this field right here, requested post ID, whatever it is. Let me just get it. We are going to get this ID and we are now going to update this post. It's a post, post underscore name. In this case, this post name refers to the database name right here. And we want to pass the dollar request post underscore title that we are just updating right here. Let me just show you this field. Okay. And from right here, you can see the name right here, post title. See, post title. So we are passing the value of this input field to this column in the database. Description would be dollar request, and let's say description, that's it. And for is active, dollar post is underscore active. Basically, these are the column name and these are the input field name. Okay, we are passing the input field data to this specific columns. Okay, now dollar request, let's say in this case we are having not, we are defining it right here up, show post, show post, that's it. And let's save it, dollar post save. Basically, what this save method is going to do, it is going to check if this specific post has ID. If it has an ID, what it is going to do, it is just going to update it. And if this post does not contain any sort of ID, what it is going to do, it is going to create a new one. That's it, simple. Now let's return view, basically not return, redirect back with success message, let's say success, and let's say post updated successfully. That's it. Okay, so everything looks fine right here. Okay, now let's just update our data. Let's say updated, update. Okay, the column description cannot be null. Okay, so we are passing wrong data right here. With we are going to pass this input field name right here, post description. You can see the mistake. I'm just passing the description. Basically, what I have to do is pass the input field or text area field name attribute. Okay, guys, let's just move back. Let's just say updated. Okay, so we have our post updated successfully. Let me just show you this post right here. You can see SAS updated right here. Let's just update this one. Okay, now let's check the errors. In this case, we are going to get the required error that we just defined. See the title field right here. The title field is required. Okay, now let's hit this post title minimum error. And what I'm going to do is let's just pass one string. Okay, you can see the title must be at least of 3 characters. Now let's just update our post. Updated and updated. That's it. Let's just update it. And the post is updated. Let's see right here. Now I'm going to basically uncheck this show post so that this post does not show up right here in the post. Let me just do this and update. And you can see post updated successfully. Now let's move to this page and you see, you can see basically that there is no post of that specific name. Let's just update this as well. Okay, let's see the error again. Let's just remove it, update, and you can see the error. Let's just remove this one. Let's try this post description error. You can see these errors are coming from right here. Okay guys, so that was it from this video. You now have knowledge of basically how to update, edit, delete a record, and how to get all the record with where clauses and etc. You know that now. Okay guys, so I hope you guys like the video. If you liked it, please like, subscribe and share. Thank you, take care.